Hi traders, welcome to another edition of weekly forex forecast on FSLess, which is for
27th to 31st of July 2020.
In this week, I'm gonna share with you guys the list of currency pairs I am watching out for next week should in case of trade breakout opportunity. If today is your first time viewing my YouTube channel, you are welcome, and then do not forget to like, share, put a comment down, hit the subscribe button as well, click on the notification bell so whenever I release additional content of this kind, you're gonna be the first to be notified. Remember, forex trading is an high risk investment as well an high reward investment, so do not trade with the money you cannot afford to lose. Here are the list of currency pairs I am watching out for next week.
I have the British pound sterling paired against the USD. I have the euro paired against the USD. I have the USD paired against the Japanese yen. I have the Australian dollar paired against the USD. And then we're going to round up things with the XAU paired against the USD or gold.
So let's dive into the weekly forex forecast right now.
The first currency pairs on our watch list is the British pound sterling paired against the USD. In my last weekly forex forecast, I discussed about this currency pairs and I pointed out the potential of the symmetrical triangle which lies on this currency pairs right here. We can see from the swing high right here, right here, right here, and then from the swing low right here and the right here. We can see how this pattern right here has been playing out so clean. And we can see how price has been fluctuating through this pattern there, but price keeps on, you know, respecting this dynamic structure at the resistance level, likewise at the support level right here. In the last weekly forex forecast, I pointed out, you know, there's a high possibility for the bulls to break out of this, you know, range right here for a more higher trend to expose the next key level structure, which acts at the price level of 1.27547. And the last week, we did figure out, you know, what the bulls actually ensured. The bulls ensured a daily close above this key level structure, and then there was a retest of this key level structure of the price level of 1.26461. We can see the strong bullish pin bar right here, which led into what? Into the retest of the next key level structure, which acts as the price level of 1.27547, which was a swing high right here and a swing low right here. And the last week, we can see how Friday bar did ensure a daily close above this key level structure, which acts at the price level of 1.27547. And then we can see how Wednesday bar and then Thursday bar did carve a strong bullish bar prayer. And then I pointed out this on the members community. I said for the formation right here, which we can figure out on the British pound sterling against the USD, it does have high probability to lead into breakout of this key level structure right here. And then we can see how this pattern is playing out, you know, decently right now. So the next key level structure we have to look out for is a key level structure which acts at the price level of 1.29878. Well, I represented this key level structure with a blue line. If you take a notice on my chart right here, all the key level structures I have right here, they are all in red lines. So I represented the next key level structure right here with a blue colored, no, horizontal line. So the major reason whereby I represented this key level structure with a blue line is for the fact right here, we can see how this key level structure has been rejecting price so decently clean right here, right from October, November, and December last year, 2019. We can see our price broke out at this level right there. We can see the nice no rejection zones right there. Price did break out right there, likewise right there, and then right there, and then right there. So what we can figure out at this structure right there is this level right there is no more holding up price as it was at the swing high right there, right here, and then right here. So for the fact, for this reason, I represented this level right here with a blue line to represent as a minor key level structure I have to watch out for on my chart. So there is high tendency the bulls may have high probability to break out of this key level structure in order to re-exposing major key level structure, which acts at the price level of 1.32114, which was a swing high right here for the price at the middle of March and April 2020, right here at the swing high right here, that was in February. Likewise, right here at the swing high right here, that was the first no week of 2020. So for the fact this key level structure is a major key level structure right there, we have to pay close attention to this key level structure whenever price get to this zone. So next week, I am patiently gonna wait to see what the bulls and the bears have to get done at this medium right here. Maybe the bulls are gonna step in, to pull price upward to retest the key level structure at the price level of 1.29878. Alternatively, if the bulls fail to defend this key level structure next week, then the next key level structure, that is the support key level structure to watch out for, should be the key level structure of the 1.26461. We can see how this key level structure rejected price right here, which has as a high swings right here, likewise as a high swing at this level right here, and then we did add a series of rejection right here, likewise right here, and then likewise right here. So the bulls all have to do what they can next week to defend this key level structure right here. Alternatively, if the bears break through right there, the bulls are to defend this key level structure right there. Failure for the bulls to defend this key level structure right there, then I wouldn't be surprised if the bears ensured back a daily close into this symmetrical channel right there, and then this could set this breakout right there into what is being called a false breakout pattern right here. So next week, I want to see what the bulls and the bears have to get done at this zone right there. If the bulls can, however, ensure a retest of this key level structure right here with a strong bullish price action, then this will constitute a more strong bullish buy pattern for more bullish aggressive rally to retest the key level structure at the price level of 1.29878. So the British pound sterling against the USD is on my watch list next week. The next currency pairs on our watch list is the euro paired against the USD. I discussed about the potential of the bullish flash, which lies right here. I've been discussing about this for months right now. And then I said this could set this currency pairs on a more bullish aggressive rally. And then we can see the play out right here. We can see last week it was a bullish aggressive week for the bulls on the currency pairs of the euro USD. We can see how the key level structure, which lies at the 1.14226, did acted as a support level. This was a last swing high for the currency pairs right here. That was the middle of June and July. And then we can see how the bulls ensure a daily close as well above the next key level structure. And then that was the last swing high for this currency pairs. That was the March of 2020. That was a price level of 1.14960. And then how the bulls again ensure a daily close above the key level structure of the 1.16071. So what is next now on the currency pairs of the euro paired against the USD? There is something I want to show you guys based on the higher time frame, that is a monthly chart frame. So let's navigate to see the whole picture of this currency pairs on the monthly chart frame. And then here comes the monthly chart frame of the euro paired against the USD. I have been emphasizing on the chart pattern which lies on this monthly chart frame. I stated the last swing high right here, we had a rejection right here of the dynamic structure trend line, which acted as a dynamic resistance. We had, right here. You can see the retest, series of retest, second retest, third retest, fourth retest right here. We got a swing low right here, and a swing low right here dated back to, that was a midpoint of 2002 and the 2003. And the right here, the midpoint right here, that was in 2017. And then we got low swings right here, that was in this year as well, 2020. And then we can see the bullish aggressive rally on the currency pairs right now. So I'm gonna zoom in on this currency pair so we can figure out the whole picture properly. And then I said it's gonna take a monthly close above this dynamic structure right here. And then we can see right now the month of July is gradually enjoying a monthly close, but we still have some few days to go in the month of July. So it's gonna take a monthly base based on the last day of the month of July, that is the last business working day, to see what is actually trying to happen on the euro paired against the USD. maybe the month of July is going to ensure a monthly bar close above this dynamic structure right here. So we can see the key level structure, which acts at a price level of 1.16071 right here. So this key level structure, we can see how it serves as a rejection for the price right here. That was the middle of 2015 and the 2016. Likewise, we had the rejection right here. That was the middle of 2016. And then we had, you know, a rejection right here at a support right here. That was close to ending of 2018. And then we had a series of rejection right here at the midpoint of 2018 and 2019. And then we can see how this level right now, the month of July right now, is actually above this or key level structure. But remember, the month of July is still, we still have some few days to go. So if this bar can ensure a monthly bar close above this major key level structure at a price level of 1.16071, then it's a signal of bullish interest willing to expose the next multi-year key level structure, which acts at a price level of 1.18107. And then this could set this currency pairs on a multi-year bullish aggressive rally. And then let's check back on the daily chart frame of this currency pairs. So next week, my personal opinion on this currency pairs is, if you want to look out for a buy opportunity on this currency pairs, you have to very careful. I would advise you take a small position size. And then if price can make a retracement back to the key level structure right here, that is a key level structure of 1.16071 with a strong bullish price action signal, then you can actually go long right here. But you have to be very careful due to the factor I am seeing on the weekly chart frame. So I'm going to show you guys what I can figure out on the weekly chart frame right now. So here comes the weekly chart of the euro paired against the ULZ. We can see the series of bars right here. No consecutive weeks right now. It was a bullish weeks. And then we can see last week, we can see the strong bullish bar right here in a kind of a bullish aggressive rally and swell a bearish aggressive rally. There comes a time whereby the bears have to come in to have their other side of the coin. You can't expect price to keep on pulling upward in a straight line. You know, price moves in waves. So price doesn't move in a straight line. Okay, price moves in waves. So there should be a time whereby the bears have to come in to have their other side of the coin. And then likewise, what I can figure out right here, this weekly bar right here have high tendency to transform into what is being called a buy climax bar formation. A buy climax simply means a state whereby a bulls will definitely get into a state of exhaustion, and then the bears have to come in to have their other side of the trend. So if you want to buy next week on the euro paired against the USD, you have to be very careful. And then what I'm looking out for on this currency pair is, I'm gonna patiently wait now for the end of this month. My trading decision is gonna based on what I can figure out now on the weekly bar formation right here, because I don't want to jump at the extreme point of this currency pair right here. For the fact, this currency pair right now is not at a very strong key level zone, and then based on the multi-year no key level structure as well on the weekly monthly base. So I'm not gonna jump into any trade on this currency pairs next week, but my trading decision will be based on the higher time frame, that is a weekly relation to the monthly relation, because I am looking out to cash a long-term trading investment right here on this currency pairs. So let's check back on the daily chart frame. Like I stated on the weekly chart frame, if you want to buy on this currency pairs right there, you have to be very careful and then take a small position size. And then if price can make a pullback to this key level structure of the price level of 1.16071, then look out for a very strong, decent, clean price action signal before you can actually go long right here. Alternatively, nothing is impossible in this market. And then if the bears comes in next week whereby they ensure a daily close below the key level structure of the price level of 1.16071, then don't be surprised if bears eventually retest the previous broken key level structure right here. That is the key level structure of the 1.14960, and this was the last swing high low for this currency pairs. That is the highest high in the year 2020. So the bulls have to get do what they can to defend this key level structure at the price level of 1.14960. Failure for the bulls to defend this key level structure, then I wouldn't be surprised if the price of the euro against the USD drastically depreciate in value to the next key level structure, which acts at the price level of 1.142260. And then failure for the bulls to defend this key level structure, this could eventually lead into the crash of the euro paired against the USD to the key level structure with the price level of 1.13378. So next week I'm gonna patiently wait to see the reaction of price action at this key level structure next week. Next on our list is the USD paired against the Japanese yen. I haven't been discussing about this currency pairs quite for a long period of time because I can't figure out a well-defined price action on this currency pairs. We can see we had a series of consolidation phase right here, and then we can see how last week bar did ensure a daily close below the key level structure of the price level of 106.740, and then we can see our price retested the next key level structure. That was a 106.044, which was a swing low right here, and then a swing low right here. We had a rejection zone right here. And then what I can figure out on this currency pair, the transformation I can figure out right here is a pattern of what? A descending triangle. You can see that here comes the base of this triangle. We all know in a symmetrical triangle, whenever price keep on fluctuating, price have high tendency to what? To break into the downward side. And then what I can figure out again on this currency pair is I can figure out right there we had a low high swing right here. We got a low high swing right here, and then the bulls failed to complete the swing high right here to turn into another low high, and then this is a signal of a very strong bearish interest right here. We can see how the bears rejected the bulls from completing the swings right here, whereby the bears ensured price breakdown. So due to this factor, this is a signal of a bearish interest right here. And then again, we can see the distance from the swing high right here to the swing high right here. We can see the distance a win, and then we can see the distance right here. We can see the distance right here. We can see the distance right here. We can see the in distance from the swing right here to the swing right here, and then the reduction of distance right here to the swing low right here, as well the reduction of distance right here to the swing low right there. So the pattern right here, it's a signal of a bearish interest. It means this key level structure is gradually getting weaker. If this key level structure is a very strong key level structure, there shouldn't be a continuous retest of this key level structure. So don't be surprised next week if the bull steps in to pull up price to retest the next key level structure, which has at a price level of 106.740. And then this level can actually act as a resistance zone for the bulls. We can see how it's acting as a support right here, likewise as a support right here, and then right here. So if the bulls successfully break out of this key level structure, the next key level structure they have to look up to is the price level key level structure of the 108.007. But due to the transformation, we can figure out right here that is high tendency the bulls may not have the strength to make a continuation of rally, and then this could send this currency pairs into another retest. And then if we can figure out this transformation right here, then it's a signal of the bears are willing to break out of this key level structure, like we did have the low swing right here, and then this will turn into another low swing right there for a breakout. So next week, if the bears alternatively put price downward and then ensure a close below this key level structure, then it is best to look out for this key level structure to act as a new resistance key level structure. Then look out for a strong bearish price action signal before you can sell off to the next key level structure, which acts at the price level of 104.463. But before you can actually act on your trading decision right there, that is something I want to show you guys based on the monthly chart frame. So let's check out what is happening on the higher time frame of this currency pairs. Here is the monthly chart frame of the USD paired against the Japanese yen. And then what can you guys notice right here? We have, you know, a chart pattern right here. We got a swing low right here, swing low right here, swing low right here, a swing high right here, swing high right here, and a swing right high right here with a multiple rejection, no prayer right here. So this is a transformation of price within what a symmetrical triangle, which is also a signal of state of indecision for this no transformation of trend in this pattern in this no medium right here. So what are we looking out for? No, based on the monthly chart frame, what I can figure out right here. So if I should zoom in more so you guys can figure out, no, the whole price action bar right here, I can figure out, no, right here, there's a lot of state of indecision for this currency pair right now. We can see the bearish pin bar right here, the long legged doji right here, and the month of June, that was the last month, carved, no, a doji bar variation. You know, a doji buy, it simply means a state of indecision. And there's something I always emphasize on: whenever you figure out, no, a doji bar formation on your chart, if price should break below the swing low or maybe the swing high, it is a signal of an aggressive rally. What I mean is, in a doji bar formation, whenever price break through this below the swing low, it's a signal of a more bearish aggressive rally. Likewise, if price should ensure a close above the swing high, then it's a signal of what? A bullish aggressive rally. So the month of July is gonna give us, no, the whole picture, no, where USD against the Japanese yen have high tendency to lead to in the following coming months. So if the month of July can actually ensure a monthly close below this key level structure as well, which is the low week of this doji bar formation right here, then it's a signal of more bearish aggressive rally to come on the currency pairs of the USD paired against the Japanese yen to the next key level structure, which acts at a price level of 104.463. But this key level structure is a very strong key level structure which the pairs have to break through. If I should zoom in on my chart, you can see how many times this key level structure had been rejecting price. We can see we had, you know, rejection right here, that was a midpoint of 2013, and then we had it right there, that was a 2014, we had it right there, that was a 2016, as well right here 2016, and then we had, you know, it right here, that was a 2018, we had it right there 2019, we had it right there closely to ending of 2019, and then we had it right there in 2020. Likewise, prices at this level again. So the bears have to ensure a very sell-off prayer right here before they can actually break through this key level structure. So I'm gonna patiently pay my attention on this currency pairs next week to see what the bulls and the bears have to get done. So to finalize my anticipation, let's get back on the daily chart frame. So next week, pay close attention to this key level structure of the 106.044 due to the factor it's a strong key level structure based on the daily chart frame, the weekly chart frame, as well the monthly chart frame. So we need to figure out what the bulls and the bears have to get done at this zone before we can have, know, a better understanding of what these currency pairs have high tendency to transform into. Maybe the bulls are gonna step in to break through right here, or maybe downward to break through right here. So the USD against the Japanese yen is on my watch list next week. The next currency pairs on our watch list is the Australian dollar paired against the USD. It's been quite a long period of time I discussed about this currency pairs. And right now you can see, you know, we had a massive breakout of this key level structure, that the swing high for this currency pairs, you know, dated back to the year 2020 right here. You can see the high. So I'm gonna zoom in on this currency pair so we can figure out the whole picture properly. We can see right here we got a swing high of this currency pairs right here as a resistance level. We can see a series of rejection right here, a false breakout right here, a rejection right here, and then series of no consolidation right here, rejection. We can see rejection right here as well right here. And then I'm gonna zoom in, we can see the whole picture of this currency pairs based on the weekly chart frame. But before we proceed on the weekly chart frame, I want to quickly know, give some analysis on the daily chart frame. Here on the daily chart frame, we can see how Tuesday bar formation made an aggressive bullish formation. Actually, this formation was being resorted due to some fundamental factors. So that is the reason whenever you want to trade in the market, make sure it is one of your routine to always check out fundamental factors that can disrupt your technical analysis in the market. So one of the reliable website whereby you can check fundamental factors coming out in the market is the Forex Factory. So check that every day before you trade. So we can see how the bulls ensure an aggressive formation above the key level structure, which was a resistance level right here, and that is a price level of 0.70241. And then we can see right now there's a weakness in this bullish upward rally due to the fact this was a bullish pressure as an influence of a fundamental factor in the market. So what I'm looking out for now is for the continuation of this bullish rally. So if we can see price retest of this key level structure with a strong bullish price action back there, it's an opportunity to go long on this currency pairs. But take note, the next key level resistance zone acts at a price level of 0.72021. So you need to pay close attention right there. So let's check the weekly chart frame so we can see the whole picture properly. And then now we can see the key level structures properly on the weekly chart frame. We can see the high swing right here. That was on close to March. We can see right a high swing, right a rejection zones. We can see right here as well rejection zone, as well right here a rejection zone. That was 2019, and the right here middle of September and November 2019. So price broke a very strong key level structure. That was the last week. We can see our price broke this key level structure, which acts at a price level of 0.70241, which was a resistance right here as well. So what I'm looking out for next week on the daily chart frame is if we can see a well-defined retest of this broken major key level structure with a strong bullish price action signal, then it's an opportunity to go for a long position. But remember, nothing is impossible in the market. So let's check back on the daily chart frame. So next week, a retest of this key level structure, like I stated earlier, of the 0.7241 with a strong bullish price action would give an indication, an opportunity for a buy opportunity. And then if the bulls failed to defend this key level structure, then it means the bears are willing to pull up price downward, and then this could actually transform into what is being called a false breakout. So I wouldn't be surprised if the bears eventually pull price downward to this key level structure, which would act at price level of 0.68000. And failure for the bulls to defend the key level structure of the 0.6800 could lead the Australian dollar against the USD to the major key level support, which acts at the price level of 0.66717. So the Australian dollar is on my watch list next week for the fact I can figure out our potential trade opportunity line at the price level of 0.70241. It's time we wrap up our analysis with the XAU paired against the USD or the gold. Gold is always known as safe haven for investors, so I am not surprised it's actually serving as a safe haven right at this current time. We can see the continuous bullish aggressive rally on the gold. Right now, gold is definitely approaching its highest swings in historical record. That's a price level of 1920.655. So next week, I'm going to pay close attention to this key level structure right here. Take note, this key level structure right here, which acts at a price level of 1920.655, it is the highest swing high of gold in its historical record. And then we can see the massive bullish trend right here. Like I stated earlier, you can't expect price to keep on moving upward in such an aggressive bullish rally like this. We can see right here, this is a steepy slope if you view this on the lower time frame. Like we did add right here, we can see price make an aggressive bullish rally right here. We had a pullback for continuation of a bullish rally right here. Likewise, a pullback right here for a continuation right here. So if you are trying to buy right here, it's not a nice decision. Likewise, if you are trying to buy right here, it's not a nice decision. So I'm going to based my judgment based on the higher time frame. That is a weekly chart frame, as well the end of bar of formation of the month of July, because gold, it's a very, very volatile. So if you don't know what you are doing, I would advise you to trade, maybe the currency pairs. So if you want to check the gold, it's highly advisable. Do not analyze your trade on the lower time frame. Focus your attention on the higher time frame. So let's analyze the gold on the weekly and the monthly chart frame. Here comes the weekly chart of the gold, and we can see the bullish strong bar right here. And then there is high tendency for this bullish bar right here to serve as a what? As a buy climax. So for those who actually want to buy at the extreme high right there, this bar can actually transform into a buy climax, whereby the bulls actually get into a state of exhaustion, and then the little buyers who are left in this trend can be trapped downward. For example, like what we did at this key level structure right here, we can see the massive sell off downward. So if I want to buy, or if you want to buy the gold based on the weekly chart frame, you have to look out for a very strong bullish price action bar. You can figure out the kind of bullish price action bar we had right there, a very strong pain bar. So I'm gonna pay my attention on the weekly chart frame as well, daily chart frame, but my decision is gonna be based on the weekly to the monthly chart frame. And then it's almost coming to an end. The month of July is coming to an end. So I'm gonna patiently wait for the rest of this month to see what gold has to offer before the end of the month of July. So the next key level structure we have to pay close attention to is the price level of 1920.655. And then let's check on the monthly chart frame as well. So here comes the monthly chart of the gold. We can see the highest historical record price, no swing high of gold. That is a 1920.655. Price actually getting to this region right here. So next week, I want to pay close attention to this price level to see how price is actually going to react to this key level structure. Maybe on the daily chart, or maybe at the end of next week, bar formation, maybe we're going to figure out a price action to support bearish anticipation or bullish anticipation. So the XAU paired against the USD is on my watch list next week. And then nothing is impossible in the market. If the bulls ensured a close above this major key level structure in the month of July, then don't be surprised if the price of gold skyrocket more higher above the price level of 2000 to aim higher. Alternatively, nothing is impossible. If the bears comes in at this key level structure right there, whereby they pull price downward, then don't be surprised if gold should make a pullback downward to retest the previous broken level right there, which should serve as a support level. That is a 1797.907. Failure for the bulls to defend this key level structure, then don't be surprised if the price of gold crash downward to the next key level structure, which acts at the price level of 1748.515. So guys, this is what I can figure out on the gold. Okay traders, that's all I have for you in this weekly forex forecast, and then thanks for watching this weekly forex forecast from the beginning to the end. Also, do not forget to like, put a comment down, share this video, most importantly subscribe to this YouTube channel, and then click on the notification bell, so whenever I release educational content of this kind, I promise you're gonna be the first to be notified. And then if you haven't joined my free forex trading class, there's a link at the bottom of this video. Make sure you navigate to click on that link so you can get access to my free forex webinar 3 times in a week. I do hold free forex webinar 3 times in a week. That is on Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, 9 p.m. GMT plus one every week. So sign up to get access to the free webinar class. And then if you want to join my VIP members community, there is a link at the bottom of this video as well. Navigate, click on that link so you can get access to my VIP members community. So what is the significance of getting access to the VIP members community? Every day I'm gonna share with you my trading decision, such as my entry level, my stop level,
my take profit target level. Not only will you receive trading signals from me, but you will also learn along. And then this is really gonna help you to become a profitable, consistent, and disciplined trader. So get access by clicking through the link below. So guys, have a wonderful weekend. Peace.